150,000 COVID vaccines are due to be flown in early next week, the Health Minister saying he'll be tracking the deliveries every moment until arrival in New Zealand. It comes as new research shows a huge number of Kiwis need to be vaccinated before we can achieve what's known as herd immunity. Political editor Jessica Much-Mackay explains.
Herd immunity happens when enough Kiwis get vaccinated to prevent COVID-19 spreading. But new modelling shows 97% of us would need the jabs to shield us against strains like the Delta variant.
To achieve immunity and protect New Zealanders just with the vaccine would require a very high level of coverage.
And that means we need to get moving.
It's a very sobering report. It tells us that we really have to do a fantastic job of getting the vaccination program out into the community.
We just saw that actually close to home in Sydney, where at a birthday party with the Delta strain, everyone, so 23 or 24 people, except the 7 people who'd had vaccine, got infected. None of the vaccinated people did.
In the meantime, we're relying on masks, social distancing, tracing and pre-departure testing, and we should get used to it.
There's not going to be some magical moment where all of the controls just suddenly disappear. Our reopening to the world is likely to be a progressive exercise.
I think it's unlikely we're going to get to 97%. I'm just being realistic and honest about that. But what it indicates is that Delta presents a real threat to us, a real and new threat.
One News has done 4 polls asking whether people will get vaccinated. And while confidence is growing, the numbers are still sitting in the late 70s, so not close to that 97%. But our vaccine supply is running out, whatever political language is used.
Constrained supply.
Tight delivery schedules.
Supply constraints.
150,000 doses arrive on Tuesday.
I'll be up overnight watching Flight Tracker.
The latest weekly numbers show 10% of eligible Kiwis have now had 2 shots. The backup Janssen vaccine hasn't got sign-off from MedSafe yet.
The dotting the I's, crossing the T's part of the process.
A process some are feeling more anxious about in the wake of the Wellington scare. Jessica Much-Mackay, One News.